sit in bar 20, violins and violas, bar 20.
This is veteran film composer Jerry Goldsmith, earlier this year conducting the premiere recording of the original music for 2001. This music score, tucked away for 25 years and only talked about among those in the film music community, is by one of the true masters of the art of film scoring, the late Alex North.
I was having dinner at his place one night, and he said, "Do you want to hear the music from 2001? I mean, everybody wanted to hear this music, but nobody would dare ask him. So when he offered, he volunteered this to me, I was thrilled.
It's not all that unusual for a film score to get thrown out by a director. It's happened to some of the best composers in the business.
Crescendo!
But in the case of the North score for 2001, it was the way it was handled by Kubrick that was so upsetting to the composer.
I know that Anna, his wife, told me that she and Alex went to the premiere of the picture in New York, quite expecting to hear the music, and got there and surprised there's Strauss opening the picture, which was quite a shock.
Luckily, Alex had a clause in his original contract that if the music wasn't used in a film within 2 years of its recording, that he retained publishing rights.
It took the help of Varèse Sarabande record producer Robert Townson to convince Alex North that it was time for his music for 2001 to be heard by more than just his closest friends.
The original recording, which would have been owned by MGM, was lost. The original music was owned and possessed by Alex. And it was on that basis that we were able to undertake the recording.
I was more particularly offended in the film itself with the use of the Strauss, the Blue Danube waltz in that section. I was offended with all the music, the way it was used in the picture, but particularly that. And I was so knocked out with this waltz that Alex had written. Dramatically, he took the waltz from it and turned it into a wonderful piece of drama and worked it with the film. And you know, I think it's still the most exciting piece in the score.
When I spoke with Alex North in 1986, he was reluctant to talk about his experiences on 2001, but he did express his feelings about the function of a good film score.
I've always debunked that idea that music should not be heard if it's a good score. How can you judge a good score if you can't hear it, you know? So I've always tried to write for myself, and I hope others are doing that and have done that, music that both fits the film and hopefully can stand on its own.
Even after 25 years of living with the film and the classical music that was in the film, Alex's music immediately became inseparable.
Alex North's music for 2001. Stanley Kubrick didn't want it in the movie, but thanks to Varèse Sarabande and Jerry Goldsmith, music buffs can now decide whether the reclusive director made the right decision. For today, Jim Brown, NBC News, Hollywood.